वन ऑफ द इन्फेक्शस डिजीज दैट इज ट्यूबरकुलोसिस एंड यू विल गेट टू इन्फेक्शस डिजीज ट्यूबरकुलोसिस एंड लेप्रोसिस एंड कॉजिटिव माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म इज सेम दैट इज माइक्रोबैक्टीरियम ट्यूबरकुलोसिस ट्यूबरकुलोसिस इन ट्यूबरकुलोसिस एंड इन लेप्रोसिस माइक्रोबैक्टीरियम लेप्रे. You have to know the definition of tuberculosis. You know, tuberculosis is one of the contagious diseases that affects most of the or any part of the body. And you can see the meaning of tuberculosis. Tubercle means round or nodule or swelling, and osis means condition. Then you have to know causative organism. It is important. You will get MCQs like what is the causative organism for tuberculosis or causative organism for leprosy. Then you have to remember Mycobacterium tuberculosis is the causative organism of tuberculosis in human and in animals, that is Mycobacterium bovis. And some symptoms of tuberculosis, you know, everyone knows symptoms of tuberculosis. There will be persistent cough, there will be chest pain, and there will be coughing with bloody sputum. In a cough, blood will come out. Then shortness of breath, urine discoloration, fever, fatigue. These are the some symptoms of tuberculosis. Pathophysiology of tuberculosis, there is a means only simple steps on pathophysiology of tuberculosis. That is when Mycobacterium tuberculosis enters into the respiratory system, or you can say cavities of the bronchi. Then that microorganism will be spread through the respiratory system and it will form some lesions in the lungs. And in 90 to 95% of individuals, that Mycobacterium is spread through the hematogenous, means blood circulation. And 5 to 10% patients, exceptional, that tuberculosis or Mycobacterium tuberculosis microbes in stay inside the bronchus or respiratory system only. And after spreading through the blood or spreading through the respiratory system, then symptoms will come out after incubation period. And after that, after diagnosis, you can confirm whether patient have TB or not. This tuberculosis can be spread, you know, tuberculosis is one of the contagious disease, and it can be spread through sneezing, coughing, or splitting, or direct contact also. Through direct contact also, this TB can be spread. Then for the diagnosis of tuberculosis, number of tests is there, like skin test is there, but important test is two: tuberculin skin test and Mantoux test. You will get in MCQs. The tuberculosis can be diagnosed by, you will get options like tuberculin test or Mantoux test, or other test will be there, Weddell test. You have to choose correct one. Only you have to test of tuberculosis. Then some preventive measures you can take for the prevention of tuberculosis. You have to use mask, and during coughing or sneezing, you have to cover up your mouth. Then vaccine is available, that is BCG vaccine, and you have to regularly check up your body. And you have to stay, patient should be stay in isolation area, and that area should be properly ventilated is there. And that isolation area should get sunlight, and or the patient should stay in natural sunlight also. Some drugs also available for the management of tuberculosis. There is only two generation drugs is there, first line drugs and second line drugs. First line drugs is important. First of all, first line drugs should be prescribed to the TB patient. Then if it is not cured, then combination of drugs should be given. In first line drug, you will get isoniazid, rifampicin, ethambutol, pyrazinamide, Then in second line drugs like cyclosporine, ethionamide, levofloxacin, moxifloxacin, streptomycin, capreomycin. These are the drugs which are used for the treatment of. Here you can see mechanism of action of drugs. Like isoniazid, mechanism of action is very very important. In MCQs you will get the mechanism of action of isoniazid is. You have to remember isoniazid mechanism of action. It inhibits mycolic acid synthesis. Then rifampicin. Rifampicin blocks RNA synthesis. And you will get ethambutol. Ethambutol also inhibit ARB, nosyl transferase, and streptomycin in a mechanism you know, it inhibits protein synthesis. Mechanism of action is important. Only one line mechanism of action is there. You have to remember this. Then for the treatment of TB, if it is in complicated, then combination of drugs also there. MRD, you know, multi-drug resistance drug also available. In that case, maximum combination of first line and second line drugs are used. But DOTS also used. DOTS, and here you have to remember the full form of DOTS. In exam you will get full form of DOTS is. And the full form of DOTS is directly observed treatment short course. You have to remember this. And in DOTS, what happened? What is there in DOTS? That means in DOTS, the trained healthcare workers, that means doctors, physician will give medication to the TB patient. And during giving medicines or treatment to the TB patient, and they will observe all the symptoms. Then simply you can say in front of doctors, TB patients should take medicines in DOTS. That's all in TB. It is a simple topic. Only here you have to remember the symptoms, some symptoms, causative microorganisms, management, steps, and little bit pathophysiology of TB. Thank you.